بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على محمد وآله الطيبين الطاهرين، ولعنة الله على أعدائهم أجمعين من الآن إلى أبد الآبدين. نعيمان ابن عمر الأنصاري، one of the sincere companions who lived at the time of the Holy Prophet of Islam. He was known to have a good sense of humor. He used to sit by the Holy Prophet and try to bring joy and happiness onto the Holy Prophet. One day, a Bedouin came wanting to sit next to the Holy Prophet. He came, he placed his camel outside the Holy Mosque and entered the mosque. The Muslims came and called Nu'aiman out of his sense of humor and asked him if he could slaughter this camel and they could share the meat. Nu'aiman came, slaughtered the camel, and they shared the meat of that camel. Upon completing his visit to the Holy Prophet, this Bedouin came out to see the scenario that his camel had been slaughtered. He rushed back into the masjid, into the mosque, inquiring and asking the Holy Prophet who had killed his camel. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam came out and saw the camel had been killed. He inquired the Muslims who had killed and committed this act. The Muslims then pointed out that Nu'aiman ibn Amr al-Ansari had committed this act. Rasulullah asked where Nu'aiman had been. They said to the Holy Prophet, Nu'aiman had fled to one of the houses of the women next to the mosque, and he had buried himself or hidden himself in one of the trenches. Upon coming and standing upon that trench, Rasulullah asked the Muslims to uncover that trench. Nu'aiman came out, uncovered himself, full of dust and plants all over his face and head. Rasulullah asked Nu'aiman, "Oh Nu'aiman, why did you commit such an act?" Of course, Rasulullah knew Nu'aiman and knew his nature, and that Nu'aiman would not commit such an act if he was not pushed to committing such an act. But it was a mistake. Nu'aiman said to the Holy Prophet of Islam, "O Prophet of Allah, the same people that guided you to my hideout, the same people pushed me towards slaughtering that camel. And I do not have any grudge against the camel owner, against the Bedouin." Rasulullah smiled in the face of Nu'aiman, started cleaning the face and the head of Nu'aiman from the dust and the leaves, and then paid the price of the camel's worth to that Bedouin, and that Bedouin left. The lessons we can learn from this story is that our morals should be of the priority in our life, because the morals that we choose to practice will teach us the good from the wrong. Rasulullah, as a leader, could teach us many things. For example, a father or a mother at home is able to deal with their children in the same manner that Rasulullah dealt with Nu'aiman. Children do make mistakes. They do commit acts that sometimes the parents will be unhappy as a result of those acts and actions. Hence Rasulullah smiled in the face of Nu'aiman. We can learn that we as parents, or we as leaders or managers at work, we smile in the face of the people below us, and we try to admonish them, we try to encourage them, we try to teach them not to do such similar acts. This is the lesson. We can learn that morality is not jumping into conclusions and starting to punish people as a result of our lust and our interests. Because morality is the only thing that will allow us as human beings to live side by side in harmony and peace and happiness with one another. So let's choose the morality practiced by Rasulullah and Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.